Straight out of college, I worked a low-paying job that was hard on the body and even more brutal to the soul. Not surprisingly, I noticed that many of my coworkers would put little effort into the jobs they were assigned. Employees were lazy, uninterested, bored. I even noticed the same impulse in myself, the impulse that said, "Don't work hard. Don't do your best. It's not worth it." Maybe there's a primal urge in us to conserve energy, to be lazy. It seems that's what we naturally gravitate toward. That's what's easy. Laziness is pleasant because it's comfortable. Hard work, on the other hand, means discomfort, pain, exhaustion. But when you think about it, which one is more beneficial to you? Not more pleasant, but more beneficial. Laziness or hard work? Obviously, you gain more from hard work. You reap more rewards. When I worked hard, not only did I learn more and improve my job skills, but I also garnered respect, became more valuable to the company, and more job opportunities opened up down the road. But most important of all, hard work meant that I could respect myself. And I found that this made me exponentially more happy. It's not the comfort that made me happy, even though it did feel good, nor was it the respect of others or the better job. What made me happy was respecting myself. You see, Aristotle believed that happiness was about living a beautiful life. Beauty is something that is deeply satisfying when you look at it or contemplate it. So Aristotle is saying that it's not enough simply to have pleasure in your life, but it needs to be something beautiful to look at in order for you to be happy. When you look at your own life, you need to see something deeply beautiful, deeply pleasing to you, and deeply satisfying. Now, you can go about this in one of two ways. The first way is to lie to yourself, which is what many of us do. You can tell yourself that your life is better than it is. You can imagine that you are a better person than you really are. The upside to this is that it's easy. You don't have to do anything, and you feel good because you believe your own lies. You see your life as beautiful, but it's not a real beauty, it's an imagined beauty. Of course, the downside to this is that lies only hold up for so long. Eventually, reality breaks in. When it does, it leaves you disillusioned, bitter, and angry at yourself. The better choice is to tell the truth about yourself. But the hard part about this is that you actually have to do excellent things in order to have an objectively beautiful life. For Aristotle, this means living according to reason, fulfilling your nature, being courageous, temperate, generous, just, worthy of good, worthy of honor, and being active. Among other things, this means working hard at the proper time, because that's the excellent thing to do. So don't cheat yourself out of a beautiful life by only working half as hard. You only cheat yourself out of happiness. Work as hard as you can. You lose nothing except comfort, and you gain everything.